Hello and welcome to this Android Studio tutorial. My name's Cal, and in today's tutorial we're going to be building a simple game of tic-tac-toe or noughts and crosses. In the first part of the tutorial we're just going to be getting all of the layout sorted, so we're going to create our tic-tac-toe board using that 9x9 grid. And then in the second part of the tutorial we're going to go through a bit of the game logic, so what happens if there's a draw, or what happens if somebody wins, or how to even place a tile onto our so-called board. So stick around and let's get started. New Android Studio project, empty activity, tic-tac-toe is our project name, selecting Kotlin as our programming language and just going to hit finish. We're going to head first into our main activity XML and get all of our layout sorted. We're going to keep this text view, just remove that bottom of parent constraint as well as changing the text to turn X. So this is going to be our turn label. I'm just going to set the text color to black, make the font size a little bigger, so 40sp, and just give it an ID of turn text view. Then below that, we're going to create a linear layout. I'm just going to give it a width of match parent and a height of wrap content. This linear layout is going to hold our tic-tac-toe board. So we just want this to sit in the middle of the view. We're going to copy down those constraint layout constraints, as well as just giving it back that bottom to bottom of parents. And then we're going to give it a dimension ratio of 1:1, meaning that this should always be a square. As well, we're just going to give it a little bit of padding so it doesn't sit right up against the edge. And then inside here, we're going to create another linear layout. So this one's going to have a width of match parent and a height of 0dp. We're going to give this one a weight of 1. By default, linear layouts orientations are set to horizontals. We are looking to create some sort of grid, so we're going to set the parent one's orientation to vertical. Instead, we'll just have the default of horizontal. And then inside here, we're going to insert a button, wrap content on both the width and the height, and just give it a little bit of placeholder text. So rather than copy and pasting a whole bunch of times, we're going to have a lot of views that look very similar. So what I'm going to do is create a new values resource file called styles.xml. So we're just going to create a style calling it row. It's going to have a weight of 1. Width match parent and a height of 0dp, and then we're going to create another style calling it column, which will be exactly the same as our row, except we're going to swap the width and the height. We're going to right click on our styles.xml and select split right so that we can have our styles as well as our main XML on the screen at the same time. And we're going to apply our parent linear layout the style of row and our button the style of column. And then we're also going to add a few more constraints to our columns. So we're going to have a text color of black, background transparent, text size 40sp, and text style to be bold. We also need an on click. And I find the easiest way to do this is just create it in the button first. So I just created an Android on click. We get the little error message from Android Studio saying we need to create this in our main activity, and we're just going to create that function. And then we're going to copy and paste that exact on click into our styles, and now we can remove that from our button. We're also going to remove the placeholder text and just copy and paste that two more times. So now we've got three columns, and then we're going to copy and paste that all together. So now we've got a 3x3 grid. Just made one small mistake. We just need to set our parent linear layout height to 0dp, as that was overriding our 1:1 ratio. And now what we're going to do is create another style. We're going to call it vertical line. We're going to copy and paste our width and our height, and we're going to give our width 5dp and the height can stay at match parent. We're going to also include a background color of black, and then we're going to copy and paste that one down and create a horizontal line. And again, we just need to swap the width with the height. So width match parent and height 5dp. Back in our main XML, between each button, we're going to insert a view. We're going to give our view a style of vertical line and just copy and paste that in between both of our buttons. And we're going to do the same thing for our next row and finally for the bottom row as well. And you can see that's created the two vertical lines. And then between our linear layouts, we're going to create another view and just giving it a style of our horizontal line. And we just need to do that once more. So copy and paste that between our others. Next, what we need to do is just give all of our buttons an ID. So the first row we're just going to call A1, A2, A3, and then the second row is going to be B1, B2, and B3, and then the third row will be C1, C2, and C3. And that should be all of our tic-tac-toe board layout finished. What we're going to do now is head into the build gradle and just enable view bindings. So I'm just going to type build features, view binding is equal to true, and hit sync. Now we can head into our main activity.kotlin file, and the first thing we're going to do is create an enum turn, which is going to have turn cross or turn nought. There's lots of different ways you could go about keeping track of whose turn it is, but I figure an enum is probably the easiest way to do it. And then below that, we're going to create a variable calling it first turn, which is initialized to turn cross, as well as another variable calling it current turn, which we're going to start off as turn cross as well. Then we're going to do a late init variable calling it binding, which is of type our activity main binding. And we're going to set up our binding. So we're just going to say binding is equal to activity main binding dot inflate, giving it layout inflator. And then with our set content view, we're going to give it our binding root. We're going to create another variable calling it board list, which is a mutable list of buttons. And below our set content view, we're going to create a function calling it init board. And this is just going to put all of our buttons inside our board array. So we're just going to say board list dot add binding A1 and then A2 and then so on and so forth. So we're just putting all of the buttons inside our board. And then inside our board tapped action, we just want to say if our view is not a button, we want you to return. Otherwise, we're going to create a function calling it add to board, which passes in our view. And because we've already sort of said that if the view is not a button, we want you to return, this function knows that it's going to be receiving a button. So that's what we're calling the variable button. And then we're just going to say if our button text is not equal to nothing, we're going to return. Otherwise, if our current turn is equal to turn naught, button text is equal to an O. And we're going to be using O a few times, so I'm just going to quickly create a companion object, which is going to have a constant value of naught, which is just going to be a capital O. And we're going to create another one calling it cross, which is just going to be a capital X. And now when we reference this, we're just going to set our button text equal to naught, and our current turn is going to be equal to turn cross. We just need to put this inside an else if statement and just say if current turn is equal to turn cross, we're going to do the opposite. Text is equal to cross and the current turn is equal to turn naught. And now we're going to create another function. We're going to call it set turn label, which we're going to call just below that. Inside here, we're going to create a variable calling it turn text, which is initialized to an empty string. And then we're just going to say if the current turn is equal to our cross's turn, we're going to set our turn text equal to turn cross. And we're going to do the opposite if it's our turn naught. And then we just want to update our text view by saying binding turn text view dot text is equal to our turn text. And so if it's a turn naught, we just need to say turn naught, which I forgot to do.
Cool. So let's test out what we've done so far. We should be able to add something to the board.
We can see our turn label is flip-flopping between turn cross and turn naught. And when we click on the same tile multiple times, it's not overriding.
And then once the board's full, obviously we haven't done anything to reset it.
So let's add that capability now. So underneath our add to board, we're just going to say if full board, creating a function. So I'm just going to create that below. And for our full boards function, we're going to say for button in our board list.
If the button text is equal to nothing or empty, we're going to return false. Otherwise, return true. And now if we know if the board is full, if the board is full, we're going to say result draw. So we're going to create another function, which we're going to pass in a title string. And we're going to pass in that the result has been a draw. We're going to create an alert dialog builder, giving a context of this. We're going to set the title to the title that's passed in. We're going to set a positive button to reset, so we're going to be able to reset the board. For this, we're going to create another function, keeping this all very modular. And before we fill out our reset board, we're just going to set setCancelable as equal to false, and also to show our alert dialog. Now for our reset board, loop through all of our buttons in our board list, set the text back to empty, and then below that, if first turn is equal to turn naught, first turn is now the cross's turn to go first. Otherwise, if it's the cross's turn to go first, then set first turn to turn naught. And now we're just going to say current turn is equal to first turn, and call our set turn label function. Cool, so let's check in on our progress once more, and we're going to click through and fill up the board, so just placing all the tiles, and we've got that alert message saying draw, and we can hit the reset button, and it sets all the buttons back to empty. Cool, so the final thing left to do is to check to see if somebody's won. So what we're going to do is before our full board check, we're going to say if check for victory, and we're going to pass it through our naught, so we're going to check for naught's victory, and just create a function for that. I'm just going to rename this to s, and it's going to return boolean.
If this function returns true,
we're going to return the result of the noughts have won. Below that, we're going to copy and paste that down and just check to see if the crosses have won, and just giving our result the title of crosses win. Now below our check for victory, we're going to create a function calling it match, which is going to take a button and a symbol, which is a string. And all we need to do here is just say if our button text is equal to the symbol.
Inside our check for victory, we're going to return false at the bottom. And then above that, we're going to call our match function, giving it A1 and our symbol.
And we just need to return boolean for our match as well. And then we're just going to say if match binding of A1 and match for A2 and A3, meaning that we've got three in a row across the top, we're going to return true. And so we're going to do all of our horizontal victories first. So we're just changing that to B1, B2, and B3, C1, C2, and C3. And then we're going to copy and paste all three of those and check for a vertical victory. So we've got A1, B1, and C1, A2, B2, and C2, A3, B3, and C3. And then we just need to check for one more victory conditions, which is our diagonal victory. And so that's A1, B2, and C3, and A3, B2, and C1. Cool. And before we build and run this, let's implement a little scorecard. So I'm just going to create two more variables. First one being crosses score, which is equal to 0, and then duplicate that line. Nought score is also equal to 0. And then when either the noughts or the crosses win, we're just going to add a 1 to that score. And now inside our result, we're going to create a variable calling it message, which we're just going to update with the nought score as well as the crosses score, and then just say set message on our alert dialog builder. Cool, and let's build and run this now and see if our victory conditions are working. So you can see we've got three in a row there for the crosses, and it's given us a victory message, and same thing for the noughts. So there you have it. That's how you build tic-tac-toe in Android Studio using Kotlin. I hope you learned something, and I'll catch you guys in the next tutorial.